Hello, and welcome to another Kubernetes Moment. I'm Nigel. Now, a while ago, I did an episode talking about making people Kubernetes experts. Let me say two things about that, right? Number one, like I said last time, I do not consider myself an expert at anything, but I do feel like I am hustling hard on a journey towards becoming a Kubernetes expert. The second thing I want to say is the previous episode about becoming a Kubernetes expert, we talked about passion. Well, today I want to talk about a lifestyle, right? Or a lifestyle of learning or a habit of learning. Now, I write books, I do video courses, and I have a lot of people reach out to me and say, hey, look, love your books, love your video courses. What can I do on the next level, yeah? So the extra thing would be get your hands dirty, hands on. So three things, right? A book, a video, and get your hands on. Now, I'll bring you books at the moment, I'll bring you videos. Oh, I am about to bring you the hands-on Kubernetes experience of your dreams. It's not here yet. It's in private beta, but believe me, it's coming soon. Now, can I just say something on the topic of books, right? This one's mine. I don't know if you can see these here. These are other Kubernetes books, right? Happy to advertise everybody else's books because we're all in the same game of making people better at Kubernetes. Now, I've not read all of these books, okay? Obviously, some of them are quite big, but I've got this kind of dream of amassing the world's finest collection of Kubernetes books and then having it on the shelf behind me, like the British Library or something, you know? Anything that's ever been written about Kubernetes, I'm gonna own it. It's a lifetime goal, okay? Anyway, listen, look. So let's talk about a lifestyle where learning is a habit. Let me talk you through what my day kind of looks like on my journey towards becoming a Kubernetes expert. So I wake up in the morning and the first thing that I do without turning the lights on in the bedroom or anything, I pick up my phone and I read something about Kubernetes. This morning I read something about ephemeral containers, okay? So I take that bit when I first wake up in the morning and I learn something. Then I get dressed and washed and stuff and I take the kids on the school run. I come home and I work on Kubernetes, okay? Then, so the way that I work, I like to work in half an hour slots, then take 5 or 10 minute breaks, just from a concentration perspective. I take a break, I'll go for a run or something. I'm listening to a Kubernetes podcast while I do that. I come back, I do some more work. Now, I know that I'm very fortunate that I work with Kubernetes all the time, and that might not be the case for you, but take every opportunity to work with Kubernetes that you can. Then I take a lunch break, right? I go to the gym for my lunch. I take a power shake or something, one of those protein drinks with me, and I'm listening to more podcasts or audiobooks or things like that about Kubernetes, about software development, about containers, cloud, all of that kind of jazz, right? I come home and then I work on Kubernetes in the afternoon. Now, I understand, right? You guys have different jobs to me, but when you come home, right, look after your family, get yourself fed, live a healthy lifestyle, okay? But take up a Kubernetes project that is like your personal pastime, right? So when you come home, build your own Kubernetes lab on a Pi cluster or something like that, right? Now, when I used to hire people, I'd read their CVs and stuff like that and be like, yeah, look, everybody's CV looks the same. We'd get the good people on the phone and we'd ask them all the standard questions. And then I would be like, what do you do in your spare time with, well, I was hiring for Linux at the time in my last real job, right? What do you do with Linux at home? And I always wanted to hire the people that had a secret project at home that they were working on. It showed for me that they were go-getters and that they had passion. Again, right, attend all of the events that you can. Your local Docker and Kubernetes meetups, get along to the big conferences, anything that's offering you a way to learn Kubernetes, honestly, get yourself there, okay? Now, when I then go to bed at night, I read myself to sleep. Sometimes it might be about Kubernetes, Other times it might be about something else, okay? And that's my plan, right? From morning until I go to sleep, I am on Kubernetes. But I splash it in between the day with like taking my kids to school. Sometimes I pick them up, spending important family time, looking after my health, eating, of course, all that kind of jazz. You must live a balanced lifestyle. But believe me, you can make Kubernetes learning and your Kubernetes part of almost every day of your life. Love it, learn it, live it.